Hello friends and welcome to my new video. So today we're going to do Penguin Me number 3, where I'm going to show you how I'm using jelly gouache to paint these little scenes that I took from the strips that I made for Instagram a while ago. I mean, a month ago basically. And you will embark on this journey with me and see how I'm going to work with color for about 20 paintings. So if you don't know who I am, I'm Sevin, I'm 37 years old. I've been living in Berlin for the past 12 years and I'm originally from Geneva, Switzerland. I'm a self-taught artist. I have never been to art school. I have never really gotten proper art education. It's mostly from things that I've seen and I've learned on my own, or I have seen videos on YouTube, just like everybody else. I used to paint more. I was painting portraits, mini portraits especially. I think I'll show you in another video. And it was always in black and white, with acrylic in black and white. And what I like with jelly gouache is that the texture kind of feels like acrylic mixed with the gouache. It's in between, and it's really fun to play with. Okay, so now we're back and you can see the drawing that I used. This time I drew it also with the iPad. I'm using this as a light table. So maybe I can put a link in the description below so you can see how to use your iPad as a light table. Just don't use it directly by putting the paper on it, because then if you move your fingers, if it touches the screen, it's really annoying. So you can't really draw the thing freely. So basically, I started by making the background and they're lying on the grass. So I mixed different shades of green, sorry. And then with the other colors, I kind of had the idea in mind already, but it wasn't that crazy. I mean, I mostly focus on the characters and what their color schemes are, so then the rest, I mean for this one especially, the rest is just to decorate. And I think it was maybe my favorite so far, even though the first one was also quite nice. Anyway, that's not interesting. But yeah, I think I really enjoy the process more and more, and painting is really therapeutic. I enjoy this process. I think maybe I should have maybe more brushes, but the one that I'm using is a very simple one, and the good thing with this one is that you can go from very thin to quite fat just with one stroke, and I love this. It's a very good brush. I bought it when I was at school, like more than 10 years ago, and I'm still using it. It's perfect. So sometimes it's good to invest a little bit in one brush, and then you will keep it forever. You can see it here. It doesn't lose the hair, which is really important when you want to paint, and it's quite steady. If one thing happens, maybe the plastic thing that's holding the hair together is breaking a little bit, but that's not a big deal. I can always put something around it to make it stay. So this is my favorite brush, and you might see that over and over again. It's very good for watercolor, gouache, and all of that. So since they're sitting in the grass and enjoying the sun, I wanted, you know, a little bit of bright colors as well. But yeah, I'm still thinking about like what's going to be the next experimentation with the colors. I also want to try some pastel shades maybe. Yeah, I'm just trying things out. And I don't have so much to say about the painting itself. I think you can just watch the video, and it's quite soothing to see someone paint. I mean, I watch a lot of YouTube myself, and I watch a lot of video, draw with me, paint with me, and all of that. And that's how I came up with the idea of making it myself, because I watch so many of them, and they really hypnotize me, you know? And I like the process, I like to see the image evolve in front of our eyes. So I hope that you enjoy it too, because these videos are not going to be so original. I mean, of course, I'm just going to paint every time. But I think it's just a good vibe. I mean, it's soothing. I think I don't have much more to say than that. My technique is not like the best, so I'm not here to impress people or to show my skills. And I don't think someone can really learn from what I'm doing, to be honest. But hopefully by the end of this challenge, I might be able to have more insight, and maybe I can also make a video where I'm gonna share what I've learned and what I could recommend, or etc., you know? And what are you watching online? Like, are you just like me watching other artists with paint with me and all of that? Or do you have any YouTubers to recommend? If you want me to talk about the people that I watch and the channels that I love, I would be happy to make a video about this. Or maybe another chit-chat while I'm painting in the next video. That could also be nice. And lately I've been trying to work with vectors, so I always wanted to learn how to use how to do vector art, but somehow I always felt so intimidated by Illustrator and all that. And I had it on my computer when it was still alive, but somehow I was trying here and there. I mean, I made a few logos, I made a few things, but I made it on Illustrator because I had to, and they had to be vector files. But I never really dug into that. And right now I'm having fun with this. I want to learn. And I'm using the iPad again with this app called Vectornator. And I found a lot of nice tutorials online, and that helped me just to start, you know, to give myself like a little push. And I think if you're into vectors and everything, you should really try, because I think it's a free app as long as I can remember, and it's really good. Actually, I think that I'm really learning a lot, and I have just done it for less than 10 days, I think. And also, since I need things to vectorize and inspiration, I use both these characters. So I made them into vectorized versions of themselves, and I like it. I'm just playing with the shades, with the gradients, with the shapes, and everything on Vectornator. And also, that's the thing. Since I'm using my iPad so much, and I'm always looking at screens, I really wanted to have one project where I'm coming back to something analog and not digital, just so I could really connect with my art in another way. And also because my whole life almost I've been working with pencils and paint and all of that. But digital is something that really attracts me and has always been something that I played with. But as I said, never really felt so confident about this or in my skills, or feeling that, no, I don't have the right material or the right software or blah blah blah. So instead of giving myself a chance to learn, I was just thinking that, no, wait until I have this computer or this thing, which is kind of silly, because by playing with it, that's where you learn most of the software, I think, right? So at the moment I use Procreate a lot and Vectornator, and then to edit my videos I use LumaFusion. So these three apps that I use the most with my iPad, I think, for everything creative. And I think the next thing that I want to play with and learn, I mean, of course I'm doing too many things at the same time, so it's a bit, that's how I do things. I can't really focus on one thing only, but it's to play with 3D a bit. And I know I think it's a software that's called Blender, but I've never used it, so I tried to find another app or something on the iPad that I could use that is kind of Blender, and I'm gonna download something, I don't know which one yet, and I'm gonna try this out also. So I think I'm going into this thing where I'm gonna play with characters and really give them more life in different shapes and different forms, and maybe it would lead me to something, to another project, who knows. But right now I'm just like playing with them, and I'm happy with that. And yeah, my painting is almost done. I'm glad, because this time I kind of waited for the paint to dry before I would start to use other colors nearby, and I was not very good at that for the last painting especially. So somehow I feel that it was nice. And then of course I used pencils at the end for the outlines and for some details. So here I used black mostly because I didn't have all the shades that would match the colors that are on the painting. But I like it with the black outline. I don't know what you think about this. Okay guys, so we're done with this third video and this third painting. I really like the result, I think it's really cute, and I don't mind the colors being so flat actually, but what I thought is that maybe for the next one I could still play with shades, you know, by putting more water or less water, more pigment, etc. at some places. That could have been nice actually, just to have a different texture. So this is something I'm going to try to do. And also I'm going to see if I can have more fun with mixing the colors together. Because at the moment, I've, except for the green here where I put different shades of green and some brown, I'm mostly using the color that is in the little cup and almost without changing it or mixing it with another one. I don't think it's a bad thing, but I'm just thinking like maybe I could be more adventurous and try other things. So I hope that the videos are not too boring, and that's because it's always kind of the same thing. But by doing so, my goal was also to film the process, so then I could also rewatch it and see like, okay, maybe I could have done this differently, or the order that I picked, why am I starting with this, or maybe I should have started with that, etc., etc. So I think it's also something I have to think about, and the fact that it has to dry at some places before I can, you know, make other details around. So it's also something you have to think about when you use watercolor, I mean, gouache. So yeah, I'm still learning. I'm trying to notice what's good and what's bad or what could be done better. So let's see. I don't want to put too much pressure on myself. Right now, I just want to make those 20 paintings, so I can really then see the result and the evolution. So I'm happy to share that with you. If you have any comments, recommendations, tips, anything, please leave them in the comments below. And I would be happy to also make more videos about other topics. I think I'll talk more about my comic book, but right now, to be honest, I'm not working on it so much or as much as I want to, or I wish I could do. So basically, I'm focusing mostly on that and on other things, more also creative, but that will take more time, let's say. So that's it for me. Thank you for watching. And if you want to know more about the materials and everything, check the description box and join me on Patreon if you want to know more about my work in general. See you in the next video. Bye!